Welcome to Cottonwood Kids. My name is Princessa, and I'm so excited that you're tuning in today. You see, this month we are starting a new theme called Superfan, and we're learning all about kindness. Kindness is showing others that they are valuable by how you treat them. We need to show kindness to the people around us. We need to let them know that we're big fans of them by the words we say and the things we do. And we're going to learn a very important reason why today in our Bible story. But before that, it is time for worship. So let's all stand up and get ready to worship together.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near.
Go!
for the heart that holds on. A glorious light beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you here on the earth.
Month comes from the book of Colossians. Let's say it all together. You are God's chosen people. You are holy and you are dearly loved. So put on tender mercy and kindness as if they were your clothes. Don't be proud. Be gentle and patient. Colossians 3:12. I think we can say that one more time. Are you ready? You are God's chosen people. You're holy and dearly loved. So put on tender mercy and kindness as if they were your clothes. Don't be proud. Be gentle and patient. Colossians 3:12. Friends, I know you'll have no trouble memorizing that verse. Now it's time for our Bible story. All month long, we are learning about kindness and how kindness is showing others that they are valuable by how you treat them. We must be kind to the people around us, but that's not always easy, right? In today's Bible story, we're gonna remember where our kindness comes from in the first place. So friends, you know it's gonna be a great story, so grab your notepads, your pens, your papers, whatever you use to take notes, because it's gonna be an amazing one.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 32.
Sally Jessup and May Lynn lived in the same town and went to the same school. And both girls had YouTube shows about slime that racked up views from across the world.
Get slimed with May!
Sally's Slime Creations.
The two girls were polite to each other in the hall at school.
Hey there.
Hi.
But they weren't exactly friends, either.
I'm doing glow-in-the-dark slime next week, so you should do something different.
Look, I give my viewers what they want.
Which is basically the same thing over and over. Rainbow sand slime, rainbow unicorn slime, rainbow crunchy slime.
You're just jealous how many views my rainbow glitter slime got.
Whatever.
Plus, you use borax in your slime. It's not safe.
Is too.
Liquid starch is way better.
The two girls glared at each other and marched off. A few days later, May watched Sally's newest episode.
Sally's Slime Creations.
She really should get better theme music.
Here's a super important PSA before we get started. You've probably seen some slime recipes that use borax, but borax isn't safe or healthy.
Hey, that is not true!
I know there's another YouTube show telling you to use borax for the best slime, but in my opinion, you should just unsubscribe to that channel.
What?
And now it's time for some rainbow fluffy slime!
You have got to be kidding! Sally just told thousands of people to stop watching my show! Well, I am unsubbing her right now.
May couldn't stop thinking about what Sally had done.
I cannot believe her!
In the cafeteria at school the next day, Sally walked over to where May was sitting with some other friends at the lunch table.
Can I sit here?
No way! She can't sit here!
When Sally spilled her backpack at the lockers.
Oh no.
May pretended not to notice and marched right on past. That evening, when May recorded her next episode, she had an announcement of her own.
Today on Get Slimed with May, I've got an amazing guest to tell us all about the science of slime. But first, I need to warn you about another slime channel. Someone's telling you not to use borax. Well, you should hit unsubscribe fast because she's a liar. Borax is completely safe and makes the best slime. Now it's time to welcome our guest, Wendy Newton. She's a chemistry expert.
May switched to a split screen with her guest, a middle-aged woman with wild curly hair and sleepy eyes.
Hi, Wendy. Welcome to the show.
I'm honored to be here.
I gotta ask, you think borax is the best thing to use for slime, right?
Borax is great if it's used correctly. I think God has given each of us the smarts to look up safety guidelines and be wise about it.
Oh, yeah, of course. So let's get down to it. You're a chemist. How cool is that?
You could say we're all chemists. I mean, just baking brownies is chemistry.
That's right. What kind of chemistry are you whipping up for your dinner?
Oh, well, it's actually, 3 a.m. here.
Wait, what?
I'm in Dubai right now.
But that's like halfway around the world, so it's night. I am so sorry. I woke you up.
It's all right.
You said that in your email. I forgot.
It's okay, really.
You're being so nice about it.
Hey, kind is cool. There's this verse in the Bible from the book of Ephesians. It's kind of my motto. Be kind and tender to one another. Forgive one another, just as God forgave you because of what Christ has done.
May frowned. She had to admit she wasn't always great at being kind when someone made her angry.
Look, I've messed up so many times, and God has wiped the slate clean every single time. That makes it a lot easier to forgive when other people make mistakes.
Like calling in the middle of the night?
Hey, aren't we a little off topic from slime?
I think I'm gonna have to restart this recording. I said some stuff about someone else I need to delete, and how about I call you back in the morning? I mean, my morning, your afternoon.
That sounds fantastic.
May leaned back in her chair and released a long breath.
I haven't been very kind. At all. Even a little.
Grabbing her phone, May started a DM to Sally.
Hey, I'm sorry about the lunch table thing. I think Rainbow Slime is pretty cool. Maybe we should do a show together sometime.
May wasn't sure how Sally would respond, but she did feel better knowing that she'd taken the steps toward being kind, instead of focusing on payback.
Friends, it is so important for us to be kind, even when it's tough, even when people don't deserve it. Even in those times, we can choose to be kind with God's help. After all, God gave us the best ever example of kindness. Be kind to others because God is kind to you. God sent Jesus to be our Savior, and because of what Jesus did on the cross, we know that God will forgive us every time we mess up. We can always trust that God will show kindness to us. And friends, we can choose every day to show His kindness to other people. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for the reminder of why we should show kindness to other people. You showed kindness to us when you sent Jesus to be our Savior. Help us follow your example and show love to other people. We love you and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, I always have the best day with you. I'm sad to see you go, but until next time, I'll see you soon.